Hello, my friends. Nice to meet you again. Mr. Get likes to walk on escalators. Today, he walks on a descending escalator, and he always needs the same amount of time per step, regardless of whether he climbs up or down. When he used this escalator to go up one floor, he walked a total of 36 steps. And it takes for him 18 steps to walk down this floor. So if the escalator doesn't move, how many steps would it take for him to walk up this floor? Why not give a try, and we will come back soon. First, let's clarify that this is not a problem of calculating arithmetic mean. If you calculate the arithmetic mean of 36 and 18, which equals 27, the answer is not correct. Then what is the correct answer? In fact, this is obviously a that kind of question, where we need to use that distance is equal to speed multiplied by time. The distance is, of course, length of the escalator of one floor, which is fixed. The confusing conditions are 36 and 18. What are they? In fact, it has been implied quite well by stating that he always needs the same amount of time per step. So, walking 36 steps takes 36 times the time, and walking 18 steps takes 18 times the time. So that's right. 36 and 18 in fact give the time. When Mr. Get walks up, the distance equals to the upward speed multiplied by 36. And when walks down, it is the downward speed multiplied by 18. But what are the upward and downward speeds? We divide these speeds into two parts. One part is Mr. Get's own speed relative to the escalator. The other part is the speed of the escalator itself. Since the escalator goes down, so the upward speed is equal to Mr. Get's own speed minus the speed of the escalator. And the downward speed is equal to Mr. Get's own speed plus the speed of the escalator. If the escalator does not move, the distance is equal to Mr. Get's own speed multiplied by another time. And this time is the number of steps required to walk up the floor as asked in the question. Now the problem becomes very simple. Since 36 is twice of 18, the downward speed is twice of the upward speed. In other words, Mr. Get's own speed is three times the speed of the escalator. We can combine this conclusion with any one of the previous upward or downward situations to solve the problem. For example, in the case of choosing the upward situation, we have 3 times the escalator speed times the number of steps asked equals twice the escalator speed times 36. The answer is 24. Going back to the previous discussion, this is not a question of calculating arithmetic mean. But what kind of mean is that? We know that the upward speed divided by the distance is 1/36, and the downward speed divided by the distance is 1/18. Here, what can really be averaged is this speed divided by the distance, which equals the average of 1/36 and 1/18. The result of this calculation is also 24. So this is a question of calculating harmonic mean. Thank you for watching, and see you next time.